helping a black man convicted of killing a white girl is political suicide in that county. I'm sure he's being reminded of that by whoever got him his job.
The way he was talking, I don't even think he read the record.
That doesn't surprise me.
Hey, Chris, Bobby, come on in, get your snack.
I'm gonna stop by Jackson Cleaners on my way to meet his family.
Okay, if I don't hear from you by morning, I'll send a rescue party.
I hope that's a joke.
Me too. But just be careful, okay?
You the lawyer?
Yes, ma'am. My name is Bryan Stevenson.
I'm Johnny D's wife, Minnie.
Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you so much for driving all the way out here. Most lawyers barely make time to call. This is our youngest son, John, a baby girl, Jackie. I hope you don't mind a few of our neighbors stop by to hear what you got to say.
Just a few?
Come on, you'll be all right.
Okay.
Hey, now. We ain't gonna get nowhere with everybody quacking at the same time. Now, let Mr. Stevenson talk.
It's a pleasure to meet all of you. Now, I know you all have a lot of questions, but I really would love to hear from you guys first, just to get a better understanding of your perspective on things.
Our perspective is, ain't no way Johnny D did this crime. The morning that girl was killed, we was all having a fish fry here to raise money for the church. Johnny D was here, morning till night, working on his truck with John.
You were with your dad that day.
Yeah, we was up at 6 in the morning to put the truck on the rack. Jimmy was there, too.
Yep, we had that tranny cleaned out by 9:30.
Now, how he supposed to kidnap some crazy white man all the way in Evergreen, then drive back to Jackson Cleaners to kill that girl at 10:15 if his truck ain't got no transmission?
Hello.
Now, how many of you all were with Walter that morning?
My husband could have never done this, no kind of way. Whether we was with him or not, he's just not like that.
Well, everybody know they went after him because of that woman. Sorry, Minnie.
It's okay. Ain't no secret. A few months before the murder, Johnny D got caught messing around with a white woman in town. When her husband found out about it, he made sure everybody knew. People started talking, and the stories kept growing. He went from being a cheat to a drug dealer to head of the Dixie Mafia. Yeah. So by the time somebody called him a murderer, ain't nobody thought twice about it.
Now they can call it what they want. This is just another way to lynch a black man.
That's right. Yeah, ain't no excuse for what my husband did to me and his family. Damn fool hurt me bad. But he's still the daddy of my kids. And I really don't know what I'm supposed to tell them about staying out of trouble when you can be in your own house, minding your own business, surrounded by your entire family, and they still go and put some murder on you.
That's right. It's not just that. We feel like they put us all on death row, too.
I can only imagine the pain that you're going through. But I'm gonna do everything I can.
The last lawyers was talking just as big as you. John. Then they took all our money and split. Why you different?
Well, our organization will cover all legal fees, so none of you will ever have to pay a penny. Now, it's clear to me that this trial was constructed with lies. And based off everything that I've seen, I think we could build a case strong enough to bring Johnny D home. And I'm not gonna stop until I've done that.
Well, you seem like good people to me. But Johnny D's the one you're gonna have to convince.